You may have heard that Einstein quote about mankind having only a few years left if the bees die out. Well, the good news is, he's wrong. Great physicist, great hair, but not very knowledgeable about bees. Bees and other pollinators are in decline for a variety of reasons. We won't starve without them, but our diet will be far less interesting and nutritious. Bees also play a very key role in biodiversity, so we do need to look after them. And beekeepers do just that. This distinctive group of individuals are recognized by scientists and policymakers as playing a key role in both monitoring and ensuring pollinator well-being. For my PhD research, I have been interviewing long-term beekeepers about their environmental knowledge. My interviewees have been keeping bees for anywhere between 20 and 70 years. These individuals are often writers and lecturers on bees. Some of them are bee inspectors traveling throughout the country monitoring bee health. All of them are holders of local environmental knowledge, or LEK. This distinctive form of experiential knowledge is recognized as providing a vital counterpart to traditional scientific inquiries. Many beekeepers are also keen observers of weather patterns, land use changes, and natural history. These individuals are well placed to feedback on the success and flaws of government policies such as DEFRA strategy, which are designed to monitor and ensure pollinator well-being. My interviews have provided some interesting and at times provocative results. Many beekeepers feel that much of the recent media attention to pollinator decline has been misguided, at times even problematic. For example, one of the main challenges for pollinators at the moment is a decline in both the quality and quantity of forage that's available for them. As the public have become keen to save the bee, many of them have taken up beekeeping. In some parts of the country, this is putting excessive strain on already limited forage that's available for bees and other pollinators. Many beekeepers are also frustrated as they feel that scientists and policymakers are not really engaging with their insights. And this is frustrating for them, as they feel that their experience provides a temporal and spatial richness to scientific inquiries into pollinator decline. Bee-friendly policies may make our roadside verges look prettier, but the fundamental land use challenges remain the same: large-scale monocrops and few hedges. Our food production system is still unfriendly to pollinators and other species. Beekeepers are also noticing changes in flowering times and weather patterns that are putting additional pressures onto pollinators. For beekeepers, climate change is not just a headline, it's something they're living with every day. So if you really want to understand what's happening to our environment and our food system, ask a beekeeper and make sure you listen to the answer.